Alright, my watch says 4:22. I'm gonna pretend this buckeye tree is on fire and see how long it takes to drain.
All right, so in total, it took about 9 minutes. I did break for a couple minutes, shutting off the hose to drain a 275-gallon IBC tote. So my setup is basically all 2-inch. This is a Harbor Freight 2-inch pump. So everything I have is 2-inch cam lock. So I have an IABC tote with a cam lock, 2-inch. So I have a 2-inch feeder hose coming off the IBC tote. I just wanted to have enough extra hose in case I have to pull the pump out of the bed. I don't have it securely mounted. It's just in here loose with rubber feet resting on a metal bottom. The kit, the pump does come with a mesh screen if you have to dump it into a pond. So another reason to have a little bit longer inlet hose. I keep just a couple gallon water jug in here just to prime the pump. So now that I'm done for fire season, which is why I built this, I'll just drain the pump. The pump does stay pretty well primed with that hose with some back pressure. As you can see, I didn't actually know it had that much pressure. I'll leave that off. But I wanted to be ready for fire season. I'm on a pretty steep hillside on my property. You can see I'm heavily wooded, a lot of brush, and I don't have a fire hydrant anywhere nearby, and I have a little bit more to defend than I could with just a garden hose. So I picked up this crawler from auction. It's a Yanmar C30R. This is the Dash 1, so this is one of the early series. There are earlier models to the C30R. But I like this model because it has the flip turnaround seat. So it has controls in both directions. Foot and brake. And then the lever is just basically reversed from right hand to left hand and dump tilt bed. I have a 2-inch double jacketed hose just in case I get snagged on rocks or have to drag it over. I'm not gonna puncture. And I just have a basically standard 2-inch cam lock at the end of the hose with the screw-on nozzle. You know, my basic idea is to sort of just do an initial attack until more help arrives. So I think in this scenario, having about 8 or 9 minutes of water on hand, I was able to sort of soak 2 trees and wet a pretty good area. So if I had something coming fast in one direction, I do have a lot of defensive lines that I can hold too, so I think that would give me at least a little bit of time for help. If I had to soak the house or soak an area on one side, I think I could get there. So it's a pretty basic setup. The tank I got for free. The pump was Harbor Freight. The most expensive part was probably purchasing the tubes. All the cam locks were purchased off a website that specializes in cam locks. I have just a couple extra fittings, a cap for when I'm done using the tank, just to sort of close it up. And I would recommend the 2-inch pump. I have a 50-foot hose lay out right now. I probably will get an additional 50-footer. This is mostly just so I can go down the driveway. I don't plan to put myself in dangerous situations further off the road. So I intentionally kind of limited myself to 50 feet of line. That can basically get me a pretty good coverage area. And if you go any lower than this size pump, you're going to lose that pressure over that distance of the hose. So even if you drop down to a 1.5 inch, which is a pretty common fire hose size, or you want to go down to a garden inch size hose for a garden hose, would not recommend the 1-inch pump. I would probably go up to the 2-inch just for that reason. So that's the 212 pump. I was just running it dry for the season because I'm done. But that's basically my setup. I think I've got about 10 minutes of initial attack. Hopefully that's enough time to knock something down before a helicopter where other fire crews arrive on scene. I know 10 minutes is optimistic, but depending on what period of fire season we're in, crews can get to places pretty quick. So that's my setup. So this is my Yanmar C30R-1 series. I just figured I'd do a quick walkthrough. I do plan on doing a couple more videos on this. Pretty handy little unit. Rubber track driven chassis. Side beds come off. It is a tilt bed. I've got it locked down just because of the tanks in it right now. Fits an IBC tote really well. Just secured with some ratchet straps. Fits the 2-inch Harbor Freight Predator pump, trash pump pretty easily. Some additional accessories. And then just basic controls. It does have a seat. You can actually flick a lever, turn around so you can drive it facing forward toward the bed. But it's in pretty good shape. Picked it up at auction. About 2,400 hours on it. Runs really well, pretty quiet, a little rattly. Got 2 forward gears, 2 reverse gears. Lights off. And just a handle throttle, the steering, left, right. A little smoky, but I haven't started that thing in 2 months, so fired right up. And it's not pretty, but pretty reliable machine. This is a Yanmar YB25. Pretty much all I have is a temperature gauge. Probably due for a motor rebuild at some point, but until I get there, this machine has been incredibly handy. The biggest downside of this machine is that it only has 1 speed, but as a general rule, if I'm walking, I'm grading.
All right, until next fire season.